the News 8 Storm Team Forecast with meteorologist Drew Anderson.
With Christmas only a few days away, we're dusting off our Christmas stats. And the last time we saw a white Christmas, it was back in 2002. And on that day, we got 8 inches of snow. 2002 also was the last time we've had any flakes fall on Christmas. Since then, it's been dry, and I do expect this Christmas to stay dry and for the holiday weekend to stay dry. Only one computer model still brings some rain over us and maybe some late-day snow showers, but I really expect that we will stay dry. And that's been the trend over the last few days, but still a little bit of a headache as we look into this weekend here at the Weather Center for us to figure out and narrow everything down. So temperatures, they really haven't moved or budged since earlier. Here's about 2 in the morning, 39, 40, hardly moving at all, fairly steady. Then they started slowly climbing up since about 9 this morning, thanks to a warm front that's starting to move in. It'll bring our temperatures into the 50s today. Also today, we're dealing with some showers. Most of us dry right now, but some showers starting to enter in from the west, coming to the western portions of the Ridge and Valley region, some of those higher spots as you head up towards State College. That's also including Franklin County and Adams County. We'll see these showers spread across the whole entire Susquehanna Valley over the next few hours. So temperatures right now getting into the low to mid-40s, eventually working our way into the mid-50s over the next few hours. That warmer air continues to lift up from the south. So here's the bigger picture. As we take a look, out to the west, we can see some showers that'll be moving in over the next few hours. I have this looped over about 3 hours, and this is just a large system spread out across the eastern states. But we can see there is some edge to that, some clearing back in the Midwest. It's going to be a while before that moves in here, but I do expect these showers to taper off right around dinner time, and then that clearing slowly starts to work in overnight tonight. Let's head to your county for your News 8 Storm Team forecast, 50 to 58 today, and then later tonight, we'll see those showers ending very early. Temperatures not coming out too far, so somewhat of a mild night, 40 to 45 with some patchy fog around. Sunset coming at 4:44, that's 9 hours. And 18 minutes of sunlight today, one of the shortest days of the year. In fact, yesterday and tomorrow, the 3 shortest days of the year. Tomorrow, since it is the official first start of winter, that is actually the shortest day of the year if you don't round up to the next minute. Tomorrow, we'll be clouding over, but still mild for the first day of winter. Winter comes, by the way, right around 12:30. 48 to 54 with rain arriving from a different system late in the day. So cloudy skies over York, 45 degrees right now, so pretty mild for this time of year. And particularly for an afternoon hour. We're going to take a look now at the temperatures across the tri-state. So 45 degrees, but look at that warmer air down to the south. That's lifting up when that warm front lifts up our way. So there's those showers. They depart. A little bit of clearing tonight, but that's only short-lived because some more showers start moving in later on Thursday, and they stay for the first part of Friday. Particularly looks to see the heaviest rain overnight on Thursday. So flakes, that's only to show you that's the first day of winter, not any snow. This weekend, again, I do expect us to stay dry. We're still going to leave in a chance of rain, maybe even some flakes for Christmas, but again, looking dry at this point. And we're staying dry the next week and staying unseasonably warm for the first week of winter with temperatures above the average high of 40 degrees.
All right, winter has arrived without a bang, at least for
sure,
now.
Sure, we'll see. We might be saying something else a few days from now.
All right, thanks, Drew.
Weeks.